Hi, how are you? Good, how are you? Good, thank you. No, hold I said thank you. There's heap of sins and crimes and stuff that entities can be forgiven for. Sometimes, every time, depending on the person or the one who's done that thing. And if they repent, they'll stop doing it. Yeah. And it really depends on any individual, which ones are like. So evil for them, they'll never recover from two that are so evil, people never recover from it, or entities never recover from it, just become evil and can't be forgiven. It's raping children, raping innocent animals, and the Holy Spirit calls that the unforgivable sin. And they're right, because all the paedophiles I've asked questions about it. There's absolutely no way somebody would look at an innocent animal or a child who are completely vulnerable and trusting and loving and kind and respectful and everything that's positive, and think that sexually abusing them and or raping them would help them. There is no way any of them would think it was anything except abuse, because it is abuse, and that's what they think it is. And I think that's why the Holy Spirit is so smart. Because it should be the unforgivable sin. And that's something that the Whore of Babylon does every day, her group. Every day. And if you join her group, they will link you up to them while they abuse someone. So you'll be doing it too. And the Holy Spirit just told me to say, he's staring like in the book of Revelation, you'll share in her sins, and like you say, you'll share in the punishment for those sins. Yes. The Holy Spirit says, even if you were abused as a child, it doesn't give you an excuse to abuse someone else. Terry, this one got abused all her life in every way. Excuse me, sorry. But she didn't abuse anyone. And I didn't either. There is no excuse for the unforgivable sin. And no repentance will cover it. And we're not going to pat you on the head and tell you it's going to be alright if you've committed the unforgivable sin. In fact, what I'm going to say to you is, we're going to get you. And whether you call yourself Balenciaga or the Whore of Babylon, or a cult, or a small group, or a family, we will still get you. Oh, and like Terry says, don't.